sa atin. Sa piging sa iwarin, magliligtas ka sa atin.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, we call to mind our sins. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, whom taught by the Holy Spirit we dare to call our Father, bring, we pray, to perfection in our hearts the spirit of adoption as your sons and daughters, that we may merit to enter into the inheritance which you have promised through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. The Lord God said to me, "As for you, son of man, obey me when I speak to you. Be not rebellious like this house of rebellion, but open your mouth and eat what I shall give you." It was then I saw a hand stretched out to me, in which was a written scroll, which he unrolled before me. It was covered with writing front and back, and written on it was lamentation and wailing and woe. He said to me, "Son of man, eat what is before you. Eat this scroll, then go speak to the house of Israel." So I opened my mouth, and he gave me the scroll to eat. "Son of man," he then said to me, "feed your belly and fill your stomach with this scroll I am giving you." I ate it, and it was as sweet as honey in my mouth. He said, "Son of man, go now to the house of Israel and speak my words to them." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
How sweet to my taste is your promise.
How sweet to my taste is your promise.
In the way of your decrees I rejoice, as much as in all riches.
How sweet to my taste is your promise.
Yes, your decrees are my delight. They are my counselors.
How sweet to my taste is your promise.
The law of your mouth is to me more precious than thousands of gold and silver pieces.
How sweet to my taste is your promise.
How sweet to my palate are your promises, sweeter than honey to my mouth.
How sweet to my taste is your promise.
Your decrees are my inheritance forever, the joy of my heart they are.
How sweet to my taste is your promise.
I gasp with open mouth in my yearning for your commands.
How sweet to my taste is your promise. Please stand.
Light to my eyes. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The disciples approached Jesus and said, "Who is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven?" Jesus called a child over, placed it in their midst, and said, "Amen. I say to you, unless you turn and become like children, you will not enter the kingdom of heaven. Whoever becomes humble like this child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. And whoever receives one child such as this in my name receives me. See that you do not despise one of these little ones, for I say to you that their angels in heaven always look upon the face of my heavenly Father. What is your opinion? If a man has 100 sheep and one of them goes astray, will he not leave the 99 in the hills and go in search of the stray? And if he finds it, amen, I say to you, he rejoices more over it than over the 99 that did not stray. In just the same way, it is not the will of your heavenly Father that one of these little ones be lost." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Sino ba ang bata? Sino ang paslit? Sino ang musmus? The Philippine Statistics Authority posted last year, March of last year, its special release on working children's situation for 2019 to 2021. At ayon sa ulat na iyon, there are 1.37 million working Filipino children. 1.37 million working Filipino children, 935,000 of whom were engaged in child labor, mga bata na dahil sa kanilang sitwasyon sa buhay, nagtatrabaho na, parang mga matatanda, may edad na, yung mga nangangalakal, naghahanap ng mga scraps para ibenta, para ma-recycle, yung mga nagbebenta ng sampagita, mga bata na nasa lansangan, mga bata na nasa basura, naghahanap na pwedeng ma-recycle na bagay, working Filipino students, working Filipino children rather. Kaya ayon sa ECPAT, which stands for End Child Prostitution in Asian Tourism, almost 500,000 children are trafficked sexually in the Philippines. And our country is noted to be the global epicenter of live stream sexually abuse children in that kind of trade. Kaya ang katanungan, sino ang bata? Sino ang musmos? Sino ang paslit? The condition of children during the time of our Lord would be much worse. They were the weakest. They were the most vulnerable members of society. 30% of them died at birth or soon after. 30% of live births died by the age of 6. 60% did not live beyond their 16th birthday. And if at all, they had little status within the community or within the family. And until the age of maturity, the child was equal to a slave, considered a property of the father. Kaya sa madaling salita, yung bata, yung musmus, yung paslit sa panahon ng Panginoong Jesus ay isang taong baliwala. Hindi lang siya simpleng tao, kundi isang individual na walang kapangyarihan, walang laban, halos walang silbi. And a person unable to do or to obtain for himself or herself is considered in ancient Middle East a child. Binaliktad ito ng Panginoong Jesus. Binaliktad niya yung tungkulin at landas. Kaya nung nagtalunan yung mga apostol, sino nga ba ang pinakadakila, Panginoon, sa kaharian po ninyo? Anong ginawa ng Panginoon? Tinawag niya isang bata, tumayo ka nga dito. Totoy, Inday, tumayo ka nga dyan. And Jesus solemnly declared, unless you change, become like little children, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven. Because the one who makes himself as little as this little child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. Bakit nasabi ni Jesus yung mga salitang yun? Because Jesus was once an infant. Jesus was once a child. He was and he is the Son. He was once a child. Minsan si Jesus naging musmos, naging paslit. He is, in our culture, Santo Niño, Holy Child. Banal na musmos, banal na paslit, Holy Infant. Ngunit hindi na po paslit si Jesus. Hindi na po siya musmos. He has grown to be a mature adult. He was once an infant, but no longer. So as a child, he came from God. He came from Mary. He grew in the womb of a woman from whom he received his flesh and blood, his heartbeat, his gestures, his language, his way of looking and thinking of things. So if being a child remained so precious in Jesus' eyes, then he must have had very happy memories of his own childhood days. Maganda siguro yung pagiging musmos, pagiging bata ng ating Panginoon. But our Lord is not indulging in a romantic glorification of childhood. Because the finer point we must ponder is the fact that the central name that designates the dignity of Jesus is the Son, ang anak ng tao, ang anak ng Diyos, ang Diyos na anak. Not the title of King, of course He is, not simply the title of Lord, yes He is, but the central name of the dignity that designates the dignity of Jesus is the Son. Ang kinalulugdan kong anak, sabi ng Ama, makinig kayo sa Kanya. And this term tries to summarize in a single word that total impression that His life made, the orientation of His whole life, the root from which it sprang, the goal that would mark it. All this bears the name Father, Abba, Father, Tatay. So if Jesus' preachings so strongly emphasize on being a child, this is because of the profound, intimate relationship he has with his Father. Kaya mapansin natin, di po ba, sa binyag, At nung si Jesus ay nagbagong anyo, transfiguration, yung boses mula sa langit, anong sinabi? Ito ang pinaka kinalulugdan kong anak. Paboritong anak ko ito kasi kaisa-isa kong bugtong na anak. I am proud of this son of mine. Alam natin kung anong viral ngayon, di po ba? Parents need to be proud, of course, of their children. Children need to honor their parents, being the fourth commandment. But we cannot tolerate abuse at home, di po ba? So our Lord understands His Father because He is His Father's only begotten Son. And this is why Jesus is able to explain to us who God is. He is able to reveal to us what kind of God we have because our Lord is the Son in the family of God. Siguro hindi na ang katanungan, sino, ano, ang musmos, ang paslit, ang bata. Siguro, ang katanungan ngayon, sino ang tunay na tatay? Sino ang tunay na nanay? Sino ang tunay na magulang? At ang kasagutan ay ito, a true mother, a true father, a true parent is one who tells his or her sons and daughters, all I am is yours.
Please stand.
Let us pray to the Father to make us worthy of being His beloved children. Our reply, loving God, lift us up in your fatherly love.
Loving God, lift us up in your fatherly love.
That the church may become an effective instrument in the deepening of the faith of children, let us pray to the Lord.
Loving God, lift us up in your fatherly love.
That government leaders may show deep concern in securing a better tomorrow for all children, and that these little ones may be free from all forms of abuses. Let us pray to the Lord.
Loving God, lift us up in your fatherly love.
That parents may nurture their children in good moral values and give them proper training and education. Let us pray to the Lord.
Loving God, lift us up in your fatherly love.
That the sick may have childlike confidence in God the Father who cares for them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Loving God, lift us up in your fatherly love.
That the dead may be led back to the house of the Heavenly Father. Let us pray to the Lord.
Loving God, lift us up in your fatherly love.
Father, hear the prayers of your children who trust in you. Give us a childlike disposition, for your kingdom belongs to little children. This we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Friends, pray that your and my sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Be pleased, O Lord, to accept the offerings of your Church, for in your mercy you have given them to be offered, and by your power you transform them into the mystery of our salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Heavenly Father, Almighty and Eternal God. Through Christ our Lord, His death we celebrate in love, His resurrection we confess with living faith, and His coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim. Holy,
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 holy Lord, God of hosts,
heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
We pray with confidence to the Father in the words our Savior taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accord with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
We offer each other the sign of peace. Magandang umaga po sa lahat. Magandang buhay po.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
The Son is no other than Jesus himself, who was once an infant. He is Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Now blessed are those invited to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. But only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. May the communion in your sacrament that we have consumed save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Mass is ended. We go in peace.
Thanks be to God.